Today we're going to build a simple electric motor using a battery, copper wire, and a magnet. Now we won't just build a simple electric motor, we'll also mention some of the basic principles behind this motor. These motors are pretty cool, we're going to have a lot of fun, and hopefully we learn something. This is my magnet, and I drew down here the magnetic field. This is the magnetic field from the magnet. That's what the magnetic field looks like for this magnet. So this magnet has a north and a south pole on opposite ends. And if I were to split this magnet into four pieces that looked exactly like this, each piece would have a north and a south pole. So we know that when charges are sitting still, they don't interact with a magnetic field that is constant. We know that when we introduce current or electrons, the charges begin to move and they feel the force of the magnetic field. And the direction of the force depends on which way the charge is moving and which way the magnetic field is going. And the force that the charge feels is not in the direction of the magnetic field or of its motion. Rather, it's perpendicular to both. So now I'll give an example of our first motor by introducing a galvanized nail to the magnet. And now this nail is magnetized. And when we hold it up, we see no motion. There's no force wanting it to spin. So we're going to introduce some electrons to it. So we'll take the negative end of the battery, and we see there is an attraction there. And when I complete this circuit, allowing the electrons to go from negative to positive, the conventional way we were taught was that electrons move from positive to negative, but in fact they do move from negative to positive. So we'll touch the bottom of our wire. This is a copper wire. And we'll touch the bottom of our wire to the side of the magnet down here and the top to the top terminal, the positive terminal of the battery. And we'll get a little bit of a spin. So just a minute ago I said that the force that the charge feels is not in the direction of the magnetic field or of its motion, but it's perpendicular to both. And the only direction that's perpendicular to both the magnetic field and the direction of the current is the direction that would cause the nail to spin. There's a lot of different ways that you can explore with this little motor here. So from this side, it causes it to spin clockwise. But what happens if we flip the magnet over? Then which way will it spin? Now it's counterclockwise. Now we can build another simple motor just by placing a battery on top of the magnet. It doesn't want to stand up. There we go. And now I'll take a piece of copper, and you'll want to sand down the ends of the copper so that you can get a connection, because this is insulated copper. This is actually a fingernail file or emery board, whatever you want to call it. We'll just do some light sanding here until the copper becomes shiny. Okay, so when you got a big magnet like this, it makes it a little trickier. So I want to see, you know, about where I need to start. So I'm going to bend it. I'm going to bend it right here so it'll touch the side of the magnet. And I'll just start with it right here. I'll just start spinning it right here around the bottom. And you want to wind it tight, or at least somewhat tight, around your battery.
And I do like to leave a little extra room at the top. And you may have to play with this a little bit too to get it just right. Because it's probably not going to be perfect your first time. Just like that right there is not perfect. So I will take it off here and adjust it a little bit. And you might have to give it a little nudge here. And I can see that it's not touching down here, so that's my problem. So I'm going to take this off and bend it just a little bit. Now I'll place it back on and hopefully it'll be touching. I bent it too much. After a little finagling, it's finally going. This battery has been used quite a bit, so it's not going as fast as it would with another battery. So this is an alkaline battery. This is a nickel metal hydride battery. It's got a bigger capacity. I believe it's a little bit stronger. And you gotta be careful when you're using this because it does heat the wire up really fast. So. What I'm going to do, I'm going to unwind it just a little bit. I think it may have been too tight. And there's a couple different things you can explore with this as well. You can flip over the magnet and see how it does on the other side. Does it take it in a different direction? You could ask yourself, why does it go in a different direction? Goes a little bit faster as well. Why would that be? I didn't change the copper. I didn't change the battery. I didn't change the magnet. It's definitely going faster. Let's try the other battery. This battery doesn't have anything for it to glide on. It's just one little raised area right there. So it slides off really easy. But like I said, with this battery, the wire gets so hot you can't touch it. So it's probably not a good idea to leave it on there very long. Maybe if I bend it in a little bit, it'll stay. And you can actually play around with shapes and stuff, which is pretty neat. You can bring the wire up real tall right here and create different shapes and stuff. I've seen people that have like the wire in the shape of a dancer, like a ballerina, if you want to get real artsy with it. There we go. Now that's fast. There you have it. It's definitely fast on. It's definitely faster on this side. So there are a lot of different ways to be creative with this simple motor, and this is just another one. As you can see, this is just a long piece of copper that was bent, kind of in the shape of a heart, so that it would spin.
As always, thank you very much for watching. I appreciate it. If you've created your own simple motor, show me what you've done. I'm always interested to see what other people are doing, and I'll share it online. Until then, keep playing, keep learning, and we'll see you next time.